x minus 3 times x plus 3. Okay, when you multiply that out, FOIL it out, you get x squared plus 3x minus 3x minus 9. So your middle terms are gone, and you just end up with x squared minus 9. Okay, so that makes it really easy. And then let's just bring down that x minus 2 right here that we need to multiply by. So we multiply these two first, get our differences squared, and then bring down the x minus 2. Now let's FOIL. So x times x squared is x cubed. X times negative 9 is negative 9x. Negative 2 times x squared is negative 2x squared. And negative 2 times negative 9 is positive 18. Now, this is close, but this actually isn't the correct answer. We need to put it in descending order, and notice that square is back here. So I'm going to have to bring down x cubed, and then write my 2x squared, my negative 2x squared next, then the negative 9, and then 18. Now that's in the correct form. So there's my answer. Okay, so that was number 5. Now, number 7, we're going to multiply a trinomial times a trinomial. So let's look at that. We have x squared plus 2x minus 1 times 4x squared plus x minus 5. Now I'll just warn you, this one gets lengthy, okay? We have to take each of these first terms in the first trinomial and distribute them in. So this one's going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're going to have 9 terms to add together. So this is a really good time to stack them so that it makes it easier to multiply together. So x squared times 4x squared gives me 4x to the, well, I add the exponents to the 4th. Okay, so be careful there. X squared times positive x is positive x cubed. X squared times negative 5 is negative 5x squared. Okay, so I've distributed the first one all the way in. Okay, so now let's go back and distribute the 2x to each of the terms. Now I'm going to write this underneath to make them line up. Typically, you're not going to line it up in the first one. You're going to start under the second one. But let's just double check. 2x times 4x squared. That's going to give me 8x cubed. Yeah, it's going to match up with this one, isn't it? Because these are both cubes. 2x times x gives me positive 2x squared. Remember, add exponents. 2x times negative 5 is negative 10x. Okay. We're done with the second one. We've distributed it all the way in. Now let's take the negative 1 times each term. Negative 1 times 4x squared is negative 4x squared. Now notice each time I'm dropping one spot down, aren't I, when I line it up. Negative x, or negative 1 times positive x is negative x. Negative 1 times negative 5 is positive 5. Okay, now I'm going to draw my line and I'm going to add my columns up. Okay, 4x to the 4th, right? And then 1x cubed times 8x cubed is 9x cubed. Negative 5, positive 2, and then negative 4. That's going to give me what? Negative 7x squared. Now when you add, remember we don't change exponents, do we? We're just adding like terms. And then negative 11x plus 5. Okay, whew, so a trinomial times a trinomial gave me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms. That's a lot. But if you line them up, it really does make it a little bit easier.